Welcome to the world of Malmark, a world of beautifully designed musical instruments created by America's premier bell crafters. Since 1974, the Malmark name has been a name synonymous with quality, craftsmanship, and integrity. We take great pride in our work, and it shows in every single handbell we make. There's a great sense of pride in owning a Malmark handbell, too. The look, the tone, the joy, all yours to experience year after year, with the proper care and handling. It's a simple task, really, and you can do it yourself. In the next few minutes, we'll show you how. Congratulations on your purchase of Malmark handbells. Look closely as you first open the case. Beautiful, aren't they? Now look even closer. Part of each bell's beauty is its simplicity. Simplicity means easy care, easy maintenance, and if necessary, easy repair. Except for the hex wrench that has been provided, no special tools are needed. A standard screwdriver and a pair of Phillips head screwdrivers are all it will take to keep your bells sounding and looking the way they should. In the next few minutes, we'll tell you everything you need to know about caring for your handbells. We've also included a special section that discusses several of the new ringing techniques that put additional stress on the bells. Because of these new techniques, a firm understanding of the care and maintenance of handbells is even more important. So listen carefully, look closely. A few minutes of your time now will guarantee a lifetime of musical pleasure. In order to help you understand and service your handbells, a printed manual has been included with your purchase. We urge you to read it carefully and always keep it handy for future reference. The most important thing to remember is to treat your handbells as fine musical instruments. Always wear gloves when handling bells. Bell castings are made of bronze polished to a jeweler's finish. There is no protective coat of lacquer because lacquer would diminish the musical quality of the bell. Touching the bell with bare hands will cause stains and tarnish. Although this will not affect the tone, improper polishing may. Bells should never be allowed to come in contact with each other, hard objects, or rough surfaces that will scratch or mock them. We'll talk about storage, transportation, and polishing handbells later in this program. Although proper care and maintenance is an essential part of owning handbells, learning the right way to hold and play handbells is just as important. Watch closely, then try it for yourself. Look for the bell-like logo on the handle. This is the side of the bell that faces you as you ring the bell. Your hand should encircle the handle like a fist, with the thumb and first finger resting firmly against the handguard. The thumb should be in a direct line with the arm, pointing away from the body during the ringing motion. Never hold the bell by the end of the handle or insert your fingers in the handle loop. These two grips are not recommended and can shorten the life of your handbell. Your Malmark handbell is composed of five basic parts: the handle, the handguard, the tuned bronze bell casting, the yoke and restraining spring, and the clapper. The clear plastic handle is fastened to a block by four Phillips head screws. The block is fastened to the yoke handle coupler by means of the main assembly screw. If you remove and replace the handle strap for any reason, always loosen the two Phillips head screws on each side of the handle, approximately 1/16 of an inch each. You will need two number two Phillips head screwdrivers. By loosening the screws, the bottom ends of the handle will move closer against the sides of the handle block. This way, the block fits properly into the rectangular recess in the handguard. Make sure that the ends of the handles are confined within this recess. Then tighten the main assembly screw. Now you can retighten the handle assembly screws. it is important that the ends of the handle always fit properly into the recess in the handguard. If not, there may be a tendency for the main assembly screw to loosen during ringing. The handguard is made of a clear, extremely durable plastic material. The primary function of the handguard, sometimes called a collar or handle disc, is to keep the hand from touching the bell. It also provides support while gripping the handbell. The bell casting is the heart of the handbell. It's made of 80% copper and 20% tin. The casting has been precision tuned inside and out on a lathe to an exact profile and musical specification. A great deal of time and care goes into tuning each bell so that its two principal tones, the fundamental and the twelfth, will be in exact relationship with each other and with the other bells in the set. On the inside lip of the bell, you will find a scribed mark about 1/2 inch in length. This is not a crack or a defect. This is known as the point of best response and has been selected at the factory by the bell craftsman. It is the point where the clapper should strike the bell for best response and minimum beat or wow. Although handbells will not generally change pitch, the point of best response may change due to aging or damage. If you detect a change, you can select a new strike point yourself just by following this simple procedure. First, loosen the main assembly screw in the handle just enough so that you can turn the bell casting while holding the handle. Ring the bell and listen to the tonal response for clarity and the rate and amplitude of any beat or wow. Damp the bell by touching the lip with your free hand. Now turn the casting approximately 1/16 of an inch. Ring it again and listen. Continue this procedure until you have turned the bell at least 1/2 of a complete turn. When you locate a better strike point, tighten the main assembly screw. Hold the clapper against the bell and scribe a new strike point. A light mark by a hard, sharp-pointed tool is all that's needed. This will not damage the bell or its tone in any way. The yoke and the restraining springs are the mechanical center of the handbell and are the parts that control the clapper's strike. The yoke allows the clapper to swing back and forth in one plane. Restraining springs may be adjusted in order to control the effort it takes to strike the bell. Before you do, however, keep in mind that the ideal setting for the springs will allow you to carefully handle the bell without it ringing accidentally, yet permit the bell to be rung with a light touch for soft musical passages. This ability to adjust the tension on either spring is a distinct advantage when ringing. To increase restraint, turn the screw which holds the spring to the yoke handle coupler assembly clockwise. The ends of the spring are forced upwards and will hold the clapper further from the bell. To decrease restraint, turn the screw counterclockwise. The ends of the spring will move downward and permit the clapper to come closer to the bell and require less effort to ring. The forward stroke clapper spacing should be as small as possible, never more than 3/8 inch from the surface of the bell. For inexperienced ringers, however, the space between the clapper and the bell on the return stroke may be made slightly larger to prevent accidental back rings. Restraining springs are made of space-age elastomeric material, which under normal use should not require replacement, but if you do, simply turn the restraining spring adjustment screw counterclockwise until it comes out of the block. Insert a new piece of spring material and replace the screw. If restraining springs have bowed and taken a set over time, they may be reversed and reused. The yoke, which is made of nylon, pivots on the tapered heads of two stainless steel, self-locking, socket head bearing screws, which are visible on each side of the yoke. As with all bearings, continual use will eventually create wear. The result is looseness and objectionable noises. Occasionally, in new bells, some bearing looseness may develop after a brief break-in period. In either case, readjustment is quick and easy thanks to Malmark's exclusive design. Here's how. First, remove the clapper assembly from the bell. Next, insert the appropriate hex key wrench into the recessed socket in the head of both screws. Turn the wrench clockwise a fraction of a turn each time. It is not necessary to oil bearing screws. Also, make sure not to remove and reinsert the screws unnecessarily. This will reduce the locking effect. Malmark's unique clapper is completely adjustable. That means you can select which lobe of the clapper strikes the bell. Choose soft, medium, or hard. You'll feel the clapper snap into position. Adjusting the clapper setting changes the timbre of the bell by controlling the strength of the 12th overtone. On the G4 bell, the soft position surface is covered with felt, producing a very soft, muted sound. The medium position is a slotted plastic surface and will produce a soft sound, but with a more brilliant timbre. The hard setting uses a solid plastic surface, producing a brilliant, crisp sound. Bells having a higher pitch than A-sharp 4 are not equipped with felt clapper surfaces, since a harder striking surface is required. As bells become smaller and higher in pitch, clapper slots become smaller or eliminated. In some of the smallest bells, clappers only have two settings. The materials, design, and weight of the clapper used in each bell have been carefully selected to provide the best tonal response and ringing control for that particular bell. For this reason, a clapper from one bell should not be interchanged with a clapper from another bell. Just above the clapper is the clapper indexing spring. Make sure, if you do remove and replace the clapper, that the spring is properly aligned. An imaginary line through the center slots should be parallel to the yoke rocker arms. Just under the clapper, on some of the larger handbells, you will find a round metal cylinder held by a set screw. This is to add weight to the clapper and provide a smoother ringing action. The size, weight, and location of this metal cylinder has been factory selected and adjusted to what is best for that particular bell. Malmark handbells are built to last. Occasionally, however, you may experience minor difficulties. Here's a guide to help you trace and correct some common problems. Clicking sounds mean, most likely, that the restraining spring is at a slanted angle and not parallel to the bearing block. The inside edge of the springs should not touch the bearing block. First, check to see the spring is properly installed. Sometimes, when restraining springs are tightened, they will touch the block. If this happens, you may sand the edge of the spring. If you hear thudding sounds, first check to see if the clapper screw is tight. Next, check the clapper felts for wear. If your bell buzzes, first make sure all handle and main assembly screws are tight. Next, make sure that the isolation sleeve is in the correct position on the coupler shaft so that the bell casting does not touch the metal part of that shaft. Finally, check the casting for possible cracks due to impact. For any other loose sounds, check the bearing screws. If you find side-to-side movement of the clapper shaft, simply tighten the bearings, but not too tightly. Bearing screws that are too tight will result in hesitant or slow clapper movement. Another cause of slow clapper movement might be lint, dirt, or polish that is accumulated in and around the bearing screws. Clean the area with a lint-free cloth or lighter fluid. If your bell's clapper head is misaligned, check that the clapper indexing spring is properly installed on the clapper shaft. Cracked handles are usually caused by incorrect handling or restraining springs that are too tight. In fact, improper adjustment of restraining springs is the primary cause of many problems. And finally, if the casting turns, tighten the main assembly screw. Make sure that this screw is always tight, except when turning the casting to select another strike point. When properly secured, there is no reason for looseness to develop during normal use of the bells. If the casting still turns, make sure the lock washers are on both sides of the casting. As we mentioned earlier, many newer ringing techniques are being used that may put added stress on handbells. This makes it imperative that proper care and maintenance procedures be followed. The following is a brief description of some of these newer techniques and how they can affect your bell's performance and longevity. Martellato is a technique that produces an interesting stopped tone. This sudden impact of the bell against the padded table, however, puts added stress on the handle and internal bell parts. Plucking, shown here, places unusual stress on the handle and may tend to loosen and stretch the plastic striking ring on the clapper. With mallet ringing, handbell mallets of graded hardnesses are used to strike bells that are suspended or lying on a table. The tone is unique, and other than the stress placed on the casting, no bell parts are affected. One should make certain, however, that the bell is struck only on its usual striking area, not on the thinner waist area. Mallets used should not be too hard and should not be used with too much force. Carrying cases should always be used for transporting handbells. Bells should always be stored in their cases and left in dry, heated areas in the winter and in air-conditioned areas in the summer. Do not store your bells in a damp basement for long periods of time. Stains on the casting are a common result of contact with damp case linings. Be especially careful to wipe bells off thoroughly after you've played your bells out of doors. Moisture from raindrops or snowflakes that has not been removed can cause stains or etching because of industrial acids in the air. Any fingerprints and stains should be removed as soon as possible, or permanent etching may develop. When polishing bells, use an up and down motion from the shoulder to the lip of the bell, then finish with a light buffing in a circular motion. Proper hand polishing on a frequent basis, using proper materials, will not harm bells. If for any reason you need to return your bell to the factory for service or refurbishing, follow this procedure. First, keep bells in their cases. Next, protect cases by using shipping cartons that have been securely taped and tied. If you need cartons, Malmark will provide them for a minimal charge. Make sure to specify exactly what the problem is. Include your name, address, and a phone number where you can be reached during normal business hours. When ordering replacement parts, specify what you need by locating the part on the drawing in the manual. We hope that you have enjoyed this video presentation and have found it informative. We at Malmark are certain that with your proper care and our sound advice, your handbells will continue to provide enjoyment for many years to come.